Hello viewers, how are you? I am Asghar Ali with Website Designing and we are using HTML. We are in lecture number 5. In this lecture, we will discuss some basic tags being used, widely used in this HTML document. And those are bold, italic, underline, and break tag and paragraph tag. So this is our previous document, and here I want to make some room for our paragraph. Here I write something, anything you write as your text. I copy this page and Control V, not here, enter, Control V, enter, Control V. Now I want to save this page and I show you what happened on front page. You have noticed I write in notepad in different lines. This is line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But the result of these writing is not the same. Here, line 1, line 2, line 3, and then line 4, line 5, line 6. It is not formatted properly. So, what we will do, we will write here some tag to bring the rest of the text to next line. For this purpose, we use break tag, br for break. And now I save and show you the result, the change of that. Only one line is showing result what I want to show. The rest is as the same. So I will have to write br tag on all the remaining lines. Here again. But no need to use here. If you want to make some spaces between two different attributes to different like text and image, you can use break 2 or 3 or 4 times. Now no need to insert a break here. Now I will show the result. I save this change and then I press F5 from keyboard. Now result is what I want to be, it should be. Now it is in a proper shape. Now I will show you different other tags like bold tag. I want to insert here B tag and it's closing here before break tag. This is opening tag and this is closing tag for bold text. This line will be bold. I save here this text and now I show the result. This is bold. This is a bit thick than the other ones. Now I want to change this second line into italic. Only I is for italic. Here I close this tag. This is opening tag for I for italic and this is closing tag for italic. I save this change. Now I show you the result. Here you can watch, you can see line is changed. If I increase size of this text. I write here font and color white. Then you will watch clearly. I copy this and paste here. Now it will be white, but size, font size, you can also write here another attribute size, and here you can write any size like 7. So I save the change. Now I go to front page of this document and press F5. Now you can watch by yourself, 7 is much larger. I will reduce it to 5 or 4. I think 4 will be better. I save and now I press F5 from keyboard. It's better. 5 or 6. This line you have used B tag for bold, and now I think I write here 5 for font. Save. Now here F5. This is better. This is better view. This is bold. You used here bold, bold tag, here italic tag, and nothing here. You can underline, insert and underline below this line. For this purpose I use underline tag here, underline for U for underline. This is underline tag. You can watch clearly here. Before break I write here a slash, forward slash, and then U. This is closing tag for underline. Now I save this change and I refresh my home page. You can watch by yourself. An underline appeared behind the line. So you have learnt in this lecture how to make different lines of this document and how to give them bold, italic and then underline. Now one other tag you can use is P tag. P tag for page break, paragraph break, sorry. This is for paragraph break, and here you use P tag for paragraph, but here no need. When we will compose a page, a document, we will write some text, then we will use this P tag. You can experiment by yourself by using P tag. I hope you have learned about break. This is opening, bold. This is opening tag and this is closing tag. And after that, single tag of BR. No closing, no opening. Italic tag, this is closing, this is opening. And underline, this is opening. U tag, and here this is closing tag. So I say you goodbye till next lecture. Thank you very much.